My name is Tammy Vigato. I'm a senior scientist in the Research and Modeling Department at AIR Worldwide. The wildfire risk is increasing. 2017 was clearly a record-breaking year. We had the Northern California fires that have been the largest loss-causing fires in history, as well as the Thomas Fire that had the largest total number of acres burned. For 5 years prior to the 2017 fire season, there was a significant drought throughout California. Perhaps even more importantly, the previous winter was actually very wet. And what that does is allow for more vegetation to start growing, leading to the fire season, that vegetation dies, it turns into fuel, allowing the fire to move through. The wildland-urban interface is the area that sits at the intersection between our developed lands and our wildlands. And so this is the area that, as a fire is moving from the wildlands towards development, it'll be the first area that's impacted, and so it's the area with the largest economic risk. The WUI, it's growing, and it's growing pretty quickly. As we move further out of the cities, it's an attractive place for homeowners to buy and live, but unfortunately, they're starting to move into areas that have historically had wildfires. AIR's new wildfire model looks at wildfire risk over the 13 westernmost states. We model full weather patterns such as temperature, drought, precipitation, and we look at not just the year that we're modeling or the month that we're modeling, but we look back at what's happened in a given area over the full 2 years prior to that. We can use that data as an input to how much area we expect to burn in a given stochastic year. We also have a new spread model that we've developed specifically concentrating on the role of how fires move through the wildland-urban interface. We specifically calibrate our model to realistically move through the WUI. We don't expect that a fire will necessarily burn all the way into downtown Los Angeles, for example, but we do know that those fringe areas will definitely be impacted. Essentially, we classify what's traditionally considered to be urban on a gradient. We can use that gradient to adjust the probability that a fire will be able to go through an area, and we change the rates that that's possible based on the intensity of the fire.